Good morning, children. So, continuing with the topic of Northern Plains, okay. So today we are going to see about the state Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh lies in the Ganga Basin. Previously, in the Ganga Basin also we saw that the states which are located along the Ganga Basin. So in that Uttar Pradesh will come. So now in this topic we are going to see about Uttar Pradesh. So it lies in the Ganga Basin, children. So observe here. This is Uttar Pradesh. Okay, this is Uttar Pradesh. It is one of the largest state in largest and most populated. Most populated means the population in Uttar Pradesh is the largest. Okay, so largest and the most populated. The main crops which are grown in Uttar Pradesh are wheat, rice, and sugar cane. Okay, children. The main crops grown in Uttar Pradesh is wheat, rice, and sugar cane. Okay, so as we have sugar cane, so sugar mills are more in Uttar Pradesh, children. This is a GK question. Sugar industries or sugar mills. Okay, from sugar cane they produce sugar now. So the sugar mills are more in Uttar Pradesh, and you have the textile to make clothes. So the textile industry and leather. So you would have heard about leather bags, belt, okay, leather items. So in that also Uttar Pradesh is very famous. Sugar, textile and leather are the major industries over there, children. And the Uttar Pradesh capital is Lucknow. Okay, Uttar Pradesh capital is Lucknow. Then an important educational center is Allahabad. Okay, an important educational center is Allahabad. So many colleges and good university are there in Allahabad. Okay, now this is a famous work, children. Okay, chicken curry work. Okay, in the cloths they will make the designs. Okay, the different design it is. So that is called as chicken curry work. Okay, chicken curry. In dress they will design it, children. Okay, so chicken curry work, it is done in Lucknow. Then we have the famous Varanasi silk sarees. Otherwise you would have heard it as Banaras. Okay, Banaras silk sarees. So these are Varanasi is famous for silk sarees. And the Saharanpur. Okay, Saharanpur is famous for wooden furniture. Saharanpur is famous for wooden furniture. So worldwide this chicken curry work, Banaras silk saree, Varanasi silk saree, wooden furniture, all these are all world famous, children. And in Uttar Pradesh you have known that is Taj Mahal. Okay, Taj Mahal built by Shah Jahan in memory of his wife Mumtaz. Okay, Taj Mahal is located in Agra. Okay, in Agra, world famous. It is one of the seven wonders of the world, children. So Taj Mahal is located over there. Then you have Kanpur. Kanpur is an industrial city. So many industries are located in Kanpur. Then you have the famous tourist places and all, children. Other this one, Fatehpur Sikri. Okay, it was built by Akbar. Okay, Fatehpur Sikri. Then temples of Mathura and Varanasi are very famous, children. Okay, Fatehpur Sikri, temples of Mathura and Varanasi are very famous, children. So Uttar Pradesh has got so many famous things and important industrial centers, educational centers. Okay, then famous for many items like chicken curry work, silk sarees and wooden furniture. And the temples of Mathura and Varanasi are famous, children. Okay, next we will move to Delhi. So we know Delhi, New Delhi is the capital of India. Okay, so it is surrounded by the states of Haryana, Uttar Pradesh. Okay, it is, this New Delhi is called as the National Capital Territory of India, children. Okay, it is called as National Capital Territory. Okay, it's not there in the book, but I'm telling you. Okay, National Capital Territory. Okay, then it's a thickly populated, as it is a very small place, still it is populated and more people. Thickly populated means more people are living there. Thickly populated and it is a metropolitan city. Okay, see how our Bangalore is a metropolitan city. Like that, Delhi is also a metropolitan city. And river Yamuna flows through it, children. Okay, the river Yamuna flows through Delhi. Then many people work in office and many of them have business also. So these are the main things they are doing over there. So some people work in office and some people do business. Okay, so in Delhi so many important tourist attractions are there, children. That one we are going to see now. The first one is the Jama Masjid. It is one of the biggest mosques, children. Okay, Jama Masjid. Okay, Jama Masjid. Then you have the Red Fort. Okay, Red Fort is located in Delhi. So every time during Independence Day, our Prime Minister hoists the national flag in Red Fort and address the nation, children. Okay, so Red Fort is very famous. Okay, then you have the Qutub Minar. It is one of the tallest building, children. Okay, I will show you here. This is Qutub Minar. Okay, this is the tallest building. Okay, then you have the Taj Mahal. Okay, Taj Mahal. Then you have the Lotus Temple. So the building is designed in the way of lotus petals. Okay, Lotus Temple is famous. Then you have the India Gate. So there also during the Republic Day, our Prime Minister, President, everybody goes to India Gate to remember the sacrifice of our soldiers, children. So India Gate is also very famous. We have two India Gates, children. One in Delhi and another one in Mumbai. Okay, India Gate. The next one is Akshardham Temple. Okay, next one is Akshardham Temple. This is also very famous and it is one of the biggest temple, children. Okay, it covers a large area, Akshardham Temple. Then you have the Humayun's Tomb. Okay, where the rest of Humayun is being kept over there. That's why it is called Humayun's Tomb. Who is Humayun? He is Akbar's son. Okay, Humayun's Tomb. And then you have the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Okay, Rashtrapati Bhavan is the place where President of India lives. Okay, so that is Rashtrapati Bhavan. That is also very famous, children. It is the official residence of our president. Okay, so many features are there in Delhi. Okay, once if you get a chance, you go and visit these places, children. Okay, see you in the next class. Okay, we're seeing the other states like Bihar, West Bengal and all, Assam, we will see in the next class, children. Thank you.